So I started in the SJA Trail, which is Canada, and that's one of the more fits my play style type leagues. Everybody finishes hits. There's one or two skill guys, and then 3.5 lines of finish your hit every single time, fight, do whatever it takes to be in the lineup kind of guys. So I really enjoyed it, and it was really a transition from AAA hockey to that. Everybody was big, everybody was strong. And my coach, one of the few stats he kept was hits, so really played into my play style and sort of developed the player I am now. And I, starting out in Minot in the NA, I was on the fourth line the first month or so. And my line, we were all 200 pounds, just big kids who would hit and get the puck and hit and cycle the puck over and over and over again. And sort of, we had guys move on and get traded, and I moved up into second first line role for a while, and sort of that progression has helped me to like be the player I am now here. And it's just been the leagues have kept getting better and better, and players older, stronger. So I think the development through that has really like made me into a 200-foot player and developed a well-rounded game. When I was in Minot, it was about 15,000 people. They like to claim 30, but I think the town had shrunk a little bit when oil started to go bad. So it was small, it was cold, you didn't want to be outside. I had a teammate who was my best friend there. He lived like 3 doors down, so pretty much any day, like we didn't want to go do something outside, I'd run over to his house and we'd just hang out. And a lot of the guys did that. We played a ton of video games and just literally you didn't want to leave the house if you didn't have to. There was a mall, there was a few restaurants, but there wasn't much going on in the town. So going from 15,000 people there to 16,000 at the school and however many million are in the metro area in Boston, it's been a crazy transition and it's something I was looking forward to. A lot of my teammates were from Minnesota, so they stayed in the Midwest and like small schools and they seemed to enjoy it, but whenever I was 12, I came to Boston for the first time, and I decided right then I was going to play hockey in Boston one day. And so it was really a dream come true to like hear from people Isle and know that UMass Boston was an option. I was looking at a few schools in the Boston area, but that was my like main requirement was I want to be in Boston just because I fell in love with the city as a little kid. My assistant coach really, he would instill in us, "Don't suck at what you do," was his quote. And he had it on the wall of the locker room. He had it on like every text, email he sent us. So he just wanted us to be the best we were at no matter what it was that we were doing. So we would go to elementary schools every Tuesday. And it was like half the guys 1 week, half the guys the next week. And he really, from the start, he like grabbed me and was sort of like, "I want you to really get involved with this and make it your own." And so each week we would stick to a few there. Small town, so there were only a few schools there. So I would switch back and forth, and I got to meet pretty much all the kids at all those schools. And so my first year in Minot, I really developed the ability to talk in front of people and not feel uncomfortable. It was nice because they were little kids and they looked up to you. But that year, my coach, he gave me the humanitarian award for the team. So just being able to step up and like feel like you have an impact in a small town and people know your name, it was really neat. And then the next year, I think having to do with having met those kids, their parents knew me. I got invited to a few kids' birthday parties and like went and played. There was one time we played hockey inside these people's living room with a ton of little kids, and they had the time of their lives at this. So the next year, I won fan favorite award, which I was really excited for because I didn't have the most points. I didn't have a Division I scholarship to show for that year, but I played hard every game and I finished hits, got in a few fights, scored some goals, and had a few celebrations that I guess the fans liked. And I'm still going around town seeing the kids, so the families knew me and liked me. And it felt really good to have that walking away from your junior career.